सुप्रीम लॉर्ड इटर्नल ट्रूथ लेट अस ओबे दी अलोन एंड लिव अकॉर्डिंग टू ट्रूथ परमो च प्रभु सत्यम नित्यत्वमेव केवलम अनुवर्ता महि सत्यम अनुजीवम केवलम ओम शांति ही शांति ही शांति। नमस्ते, वंदे मातरम, गुड मॉर्निंग, वेलकम ऑल। टुडे द टॉपिक ऑफ द स्पिरिचुअल डिस्कशन विल बी ऑन ऑरोविल। ऑरोविल एज वी नो इज द सिटी ऑफ डॉन, सो दिस इज सिचुएटेड इन पांडिचेरी, ऑफ कोर्स इन द प्रोविंस ऑफ तमिलनाडु, बॉर्डरिंग प्लेस कॉन्स्टिट्यूटिंग पांडिचेरी एंड तमिलनाडु, ऑफ कोर्स एट द बॉर्डर इट इज कमिंग अंडर द डायरेक्टली इट इज ऑफ कोर्स बिलोंग्स टू पांडिचेरी, स्टिल देन द रियल सिचुएशन इट इज कमिंग जस्ट बॉर्डरिंग अप टू तमिलनाडु द स्टेट व्हिच वी नो इट इज ऑफ कोर्स ए साउथ इंडियन स्टेट। So on Aurovil we are going to discuss today on spiritual discussion will be based on the Aurovil. So couple of examples we'll take almost with the philosophy and the visions, it will be derived from the visions and philosophy of the mother, of the divine mother. So this topic of discussion is on Aurovil. As we know, it is written as the beginning of the new creation. Of course, Aurobindo had the very much vision, one good vision, a new creation from the old shall rise. A knowledge inarticulate finds speech. A beauty suppressed burst into paradise bloom. Beauty conquered the resisting world. Then the superconscient conscious grow on the earth. The eternal's wonders shall join the dance of time. So Sri Aurobindo had a beautiful view on the new creation. A new creation from the world shall rise. Anyway, we are going to discuss something on the city of dawn, the city of Sri Aurobindo. Good discussion and is a good place. Aurovil, of course, it is known as the city of dawn, the city of Sri Aurobindo. As it was established on 28th February 1968, Mother inaugurated the city. From that day, Mother calls it Aurovil, the city of dawn, the city of Sri Aurobindo. In the beginning of this new creation, years ago, the Mother had foreseen a model township. A model township, Mother had a vision, of course she designed, the symbol of humanity and the world brotherhood. This new city Mother designed in her vision, that was a model township, a symbol of humanity, human unity and the world brotherhood. So in its foundation, of course it is Aurovil. Foundation was on 28th February 1968, inaugurated by the Mother. It was almost not only the inauguration, the vision and the designation, everything was done by the Divine Mother. City of dawn and city of Sri Aurobindo. So it is in its foundation, earth was mixed the soil of about 120 countries. The urns, the soil was brought from the, especially by flight or any means, it was brought the soil from 120 countries of the world, it was taken. The soil of Sri Aurobindo Ashram and soil of Aurovil, everything was mixed. It was in this foundation, the urn is mixed, in the entire urn, it was mixed with the soil from 120 countries and of the world, and the soil of Sri Aurobindo Ashram and the soil of Aurovil, it was mixed in the urn there itself before the foundation was there. In its chapter lays down one condition. To live in it, one must be a willing servitor of the divine consciousness. People from the various parts of the world, from nook and corner, people will come, they will stable, they will settle there. It is like a divine spot, the city of the dawn, it is already mentioned. So this wonderful city, the main ambition, the main objective was there, the main condition was there, to live in it. It means it is in Aurovil, one must be a willing servitor of the divine consciousness. Divine consciousness, one will first be a willing servitor of the divine consciousness. That is the precondition and only condition, one condition. This is but one center of relation, radiation of Sri Aurobindo's power and world vision. In another word, what is what it really represents? Sri Aurobindo, it represents, but it is the center of radiation of Sri Aurobindo's power and world vision. Sri Aurobindo's power of world's power and world vision, it is a great radiation, say this Auroville, the city of dawn. Now, all the world over the centers have been started for the teaching and practice of the Sri Aurobindo's yoga. The next object is that entire world, the people who will stay there, and it will be a radiation. From there, the emergence of the Sri Aurobindo's teaching and practice of Sri Aurobindo's yoga, it will emerge from there. So it is called the new age of the spirit. The new age of the spirit dawns upon the earth. Very spectacular, very really the thing to be noted. The new age of the spirit dawns on the earth. It is the rebirth of India, the rebirth of the world. Very spectacular, very attractive lines it is given. The new age of the spirit dawns upon the earth. New age of the spirit dawns upon the earth. It is the rebirth of the India and it is the rebirth of the world. So it is the decisive action direct from the Supreme. As we know, on Sri Aurobindo's manifestation on earth, Mother gives the beautiful message on Sri Aurobindo's manifestation. What Sri Aurobindo represents in the world's history is not a teaching, not even a revelation. It is a decisive action direct from the Supreme. So it is the decisive action direct from the Supreme in the world's history, which Sri Aurobindo represents, and the things that we are promised are fulfilled. Already we have listened to the messages given, as given by Mother in two different formats. Formats in prayer and meditation before, and the same thing it was repeated, but in another term, in the promising and fulfilled tone, it is a very interesting tone. Lord, thou willst and I execute, one thing. Things that we are promised shall be fulfilled in one condition, it was the intermediary. Things that we are promised shall be fulfilled. And after the fulfillment, Mother announces, things that we are promised are fulfilled. So the things that we are promised are fulfilled. It is done. The new creation is there. The clear is there. It is the reflection and radiation of the Sri Aurobindo's teaching and yoga. It is specially known as the city of dawn, the city of Sri Aurobindo. So the symbolically, it is a model township, a symbol of human unity and world brotherhood. It represents all these things in it. Teaching and practice of Sri Aurobindo's yoga, it is the most important place, the most vital place. It is the center. Pivot. So the new age of the spirit dawns upon the earth. It is the rebirth of India and the rebirth of the world. So the decisive action derived from the Supreme, which Sri Aurobindo represents in the world's history, which Sri Aurobindo represents, and the things that we are promised are fulfilled. No more to be done, it is fulfilled. Srimad Sri Aurobindo, the emanation of the Supreme, came down upon the earth, manifested rather here, to announce a new world and a new race that is supramental, and it is the focus, it is the focal center. So, couple of lines we'll recite here from Savitri, very interesting things. I saw the omnipotent flaming pioneers upon the new race, what is manifesting on earth, which are to be shown in this earth, here in the quotes here. I saw the omnipotent flaming pioneers over the heavenly forge which turned towards life. Come crowding down the amber stairs of birth. They are coming. It is inclining. It is actually inclining. Come crowding down the amber stairs of birth. So what are they? What about the new creations here in the course here? Forerunners of a divine multitude. Out of the paths of the morning star they came. Done. And here also, here in the course, out of the paths of the morning star they came. Where are they really? I saw them cross the twilight of an age. A twilight of an age they have crossed, I saw them. How they are, how they look to be. It is a big example, big narration, of course, by Sri Aurobindo. But one or two lines I want to quote here. Sri Aurobindo quotes here, the sun-eyed children of a marvelous dawn, the architects of immortality, like this it is given. Now, Sri Aurobindo gives, Mothers has a couple of things, messages on Aurobindo. Aurobindo is the first attempt in the experiment. Aurobindo is the first attempt in the experiment. A new world will be born if men consent to strive for the transformation. If they consent only, the condition is consent. and the search for sincerity, it can be done. It took millennia to evolve from animal to man. The evolution from animal to man, it took around the millennials. And today man, so who claim so far the finest animal, this man, it take millennia. Thanks to his mind, man's mind, can accelerate things and will. That mind can be accelerated and also his will can be accelerated for the transformation towards a new man who will be God. This God, shortly we have discussed, solid children of a marvelous dawn, glory architecture, text of immortality like this, mother quotes, it is the first attempt. Then second quotation, mother's quotes here, give all you have, this is the beginning. Give all you have, this is the beginning. Give all you do, this is the way. Give all you are, that is the fulfillment. So these are the conditions we have to give yourself. The second message comes on Auroville. Auroville belongs to nobody, mother quotes. It belongs to nobody in the particular. So it is a universal land. Every universal consciousness has to manifest here. It is for the radiation of the Sri Aurobindo's consciousness, Sri Aurobindo's yoga. It is the teaching place. It belongs to nobody in particular. Auroville belongs to humanity as a whole, not to anybody, any purpose, any country, nothing like this. It is a humanity as a whole it belongs to. Then Sri Aurobindo quotes here, mother quotes here, as one must be the willing servitor of the divine consciousness. This is the condition, willing servitor of the divine consciousness. And then next one. In 1954, mother had envisioned that there should be a super somewhere upon the earth, a place of that no nation could claim as its sole property. Nation should claim its own property. A place where the human beings of goodwill, sincerity, with their aspiration could live freely as the citizens of the world, with their goodwill, with their sincerity, they can settle there, obeying to the one simply authority, and that is the supreme truth, a place of place conquered humanity, where all the fighting instincts of the man would be used exclusively to conquer the causes of his suffering and his mission to surmount this weakness and ignorance. This weakness and this ignorance, it has to be surmounted. A new world will be done and newly it will be formed. Nobody can claim it. Then greeting from the Auroville to all men of the goodwill, mother quoted with the greetings, are invited to Auroville all those who thirst for progress and aspire to a true life. So who are lead the divine life, it is a call to them. On the golden dawn, all those who aspire, open yourself to the new force. The aspiration to open yourself to a new force, that is the most important call given by mother. Mother called 29th February the golden day, the day of the Lord, in commemoration of the supramental manifestation of Earth, which took place during the 29th February 1956. So my soul and his indissolubly linked in one task for which our lives were born. To raise the world to God in deathless light, to bring God down to the world on earth we came, to change the earthly life to life divine. So like this it is given, this is the truth we are giving. And mother quotes it, in Sri Aurobindo's very brilliant bright lines it is also quoted. It is the first attempt, of course mother quotes it, it is the first attempt for the supramental elevation. About that place for meditation, your mother gives the message. It is a place for meditation for those who really wants to meditate. Those who are serious and sincere. For them, who are serious for their meditation, they are allowed. In Auroville, you can find the people of all around the world. They are taking their shelter in there, having some business, their products, everything is there. You can find solar kitchen is there, new creation is there. All the countrymen, they come and move, who are the followers of the Sri Aurobindo's philosophy and mother. Thank you, here to stop. Vande Mataram.